So now let's look at the whole schematic of a simple charge couple device. Here I'm basically showing an animation of each and every layer of a charge couple device. We are going to basically now peel this back out as an onion and look at each one of them separately. But of course, point is, light is coming down this way and hitting a variety of layers. And then, of course, it hits the bottom layer where actually the current is stored. Let's again look at this by peeling the onion layer by layer. So the first layer basically has a little bit of an optical flavor. It's what is referred to as a microlens. What in essence it does, it captures the light and directs it towards the light sensitive areas beneath it. So when light hits these types of things, it focuses it down to the next layer so that nothing is lost. The next layer is referred to as the hot mirror. This is where some of the simple filtering is done. So in the case of the film, we saw the example of a UV filter. Well, this is somewhat similar. Basically, it lets visible light pass, but reflects light in the invisible spectrum and basically doesn't and prevents it from hitting the sensors below. So this does simple sort of filtering and prevents the unnecessary light to hit. Of course, different types of cameras would do different things. So for example, if you wanted to build a UV camera, this would not be filtering out the UV light. In fact, would be amplifying it. This is what's referred to as a color filter. Remember, light has lots of constituent colors. Most of the time, we try to represent them or at least capture them in RGB format. And that's what we're going to try to understand how to do here. So in essence, the photodiodes that are below it are actually colorblind. They basically want to capture the intensity. So this is where we kind of start now looking at and separating out the colors. This is usually referred to as a Baird array, and we'll talk about Baird arrays in a bit. Basically what it does, it takes a color and separates the light into red, green, and blue. And once it's converted into red, green, and blue, it hits the photodiodes that are below, which are then measure the intensity of it. Of course, this pattern is unique, and knowing this pattern is essential because it'll tell us how to be able to convert the value from, in this case, two greens, red and a blue, to figure out what would be the value at this point of the image. So as noted, these are the photodiodes. This is exactly where the light energy that now actually is hitting each one of these is converted to electrons and carries a strong negative charge. The final layer is the well, or sometimes referred to as a depletion layer. This is where electrons are collected, and usually there is a processor that charges the photodiodes with a positive charge, and then of course all the negative charges basically are stored and collected on this layer. So in essence, when you're pressing a shutter, what you're doing is of course opening the shutter and also giving a charge to this device so that can it capture all of this stuff. In case of a chemical film, all you need to do is open the shutter, and that's when exactly the storage happens. And of course, when the storage happens, you move the film across. In this one, all of it is stored, captured off, and we'll talk about that in a bit too. So in essence, we peeled this whole onion and we saw all the details of how light goes all the way and then ends up as a stored electrical set of values, which are then converted to pixels.